Today is Saturday, September the 17th, 2011. The time now is about 20 after 4. The rally in support of the Toronto District School Board by the Muslim community pretty well has come to an end. However, I've had the opportunity to get the young lady that was at the initial protest, I think in August. And so she's willing to sort of be interviewed by me, Dwight, from For His Glory 700. So here she is. I'll just give her a moment, and then I'll proceed to ask a question or two.
I love
Are you on our list?
Hi. Okay, so here we are.
All right.
And as I was saying, in relationship to this recording, this is the brave Muslim young lady that was here at the first protest. I believe it was held in August.
She July 25th, the first one.
Was it the first one? My apologies, you're right. It was July 25th, you're right. I remember now. Shame on me. So you see, she's outsmarting me. But the point of the matter is I wanted to give her the opportunity to present her case because she was there, as she correctly stated, on July the 25th, 2011. And she's actually a big part of today's appreciation rally for TDSB. So I'm going to ask her a few questions. They're not going to be difficult questions, questions that she's already familiar with. And the first question I'm going to ask, which you've heard a million times, is why is it okay for the TDSB to allow Muslim students to have prayers in a public school on Friday, specifically public schools?
I don't think it's really the matter of Muslim prayers, because other prayers are allowed in other schools, but specifically for this school, there is Muslim prayers, just because the majority are Muslims and they need those accommodations in that school.
Okay, but what about the students that are not Muslims? What would your comment be in regards to that?
Well, if they would like their accommodation, I think they should take it up with the principal, and I think he'd have no problem with that, because I actually spoken to him, and if there was any other accommodations, he would say yes.
But you know what, there's going to be people that watch this video and they're going to say, you know what, wait a minute, this is a public school, it's a secular school, whether it be Muslim, Jewish, Christian, whatever, there should be no form of religious practice whatsoever in a public school. What's your thoughts on that?
For my thoughts, for this, the reason why specifically for the school there is the prayers is because the majority of the students for Friday prayer would leave and they wouldn't come back. So it would be outside of the community that would have the problem, and also inside of the school, because the curriculum wouldn't be finished. They wouldn't be able to complete classes, because for students, come on, you're 12 to 14 years old, okay, I have Fridays off now, because all you need to do is go to prayer, and afterwards they can go wherever they want, they are assigned out, right? So instead of those issues being outside of the school and say God knows where they're going to go, the students, and what they're going to do, or if they are in trouble, or they get hit, who knows what, instead the school is allowed, okay, instead of students walking 15 minutes or so after going up, washing, then conducting the prayer, then coming back, would even have time to finish the lunch and to come back to school, and they would come back to school late. This is 400 students leaving the school. And afterwards, coming back to class, or not even coming back to class at all, instead of that happening, you have the students come after lunch, they go conduct their 15 to 30 minutes of prayer, and they go back to class. Making it simple as that, making it safety, keeping the safety inside of the school, and no issues outside.
Okay, some would say, well, wait a minute, it is a public school board, it's not the public school board's responsibility to accommodate them. Why should this be any different? There's going to be some that watch this video and they're going to say, well, wait a minute, it's still a public school board, regardless of the fact that the majority of the students are Muslims. It's not the school board's responsibility to accommodate them in this way. What would be your comments on that?
Well, I think they should be allowing these accommodations. This is what the students want, and they should listen to them. This is what the community needs. It's like, hey, listen, this is what the students want. They need the space. Let's provide it for them.
Right. Okay, thank you very much. Now, for those that are in support of what you're doing, how can they get in contact with you?
In contact with me?
Yeah, for the cause, because the Interfaith Coalition has said that they're going to continue this fight, because as far as they're concerned, the actions of TDSB is illegal, because there's supposed to be a separation of church and state. And so they're going to continue to protest against what they feel is actions by the school board that is discriminatory against other faith systems.
Well, they could contact me. I don't know if I'd feel comfortable giving out my email.
No, no, you don't have to do that. I'm just saying, are you a part of a greater organization that they can reach you through or what have you?
No, I'm just a York University student.
Okay, wonderful. I want to thank you so much for taking your time out. This is Dwight from Forest Glory, and your name is?
Mary.
Thank you very much, man. God bless.